The announcement out of President Biden early this morning. Also, what 89 Democratic representatives are urging the entire Democratic Party to support within the next stimulus package that is now in the Senate. And President Biden announcing he'll be running for a second term in 2024. And what dollar stores are now going to be implementing. All of that plus more in this video. Let's get into this right away. But really fast before we do, thank you so much for joining me. If you're new here, or if you haven't done so yet, make sure to hit the subscribe button right down below the video, as I'm here each and every day with all of the latest updates as things are changing very rapidly right now. If you're returning, hey, welcome back. Thank you so much for joining me once again. It's great to have you here. I truly appreciate your continued support. As you know, things are changing rapidly, and I'm here for you each and every day with all of those updates as they're being announced. So again, subscribe down below if you haven't done so yet, and let's get right into this. All right, so right away early this morning, President Biden was out with an announcement that they're going to be releasing 50 million barrels out of the strategic petroleum reserves to help alleviate some of the prices at the gas pump. Now, here's the deal with this. Yes, they're going to be releasing 50 million barrels of oil to help lower gas prices, but this is going to take a very long time to actually hit the pumps and actually start impacting all of us out there. So if we're looking for lower gas prices going into the Thanksgiving Day holiday, well, unfortunately, it's not going to happen by then. It's going to take several weeks for these prices to actually hit the actual gas stations and lower the prices for all of us. And according to what experts are saying, it's probably only going to lower the price maybe 20, maybe 25, maybe 30, maybe even 40 cents in some areas. It's not going to significantly lower prices. However, as I have been saying for many days now, and realistically many weeks, literally at this point, every single penny counts. So I guess it helps a little bit, but this is also in conjunction with other announcements that came out at the same time out of other countries, including China, India, Japan, South Korea, and the United Kingdom, who are all going to be tapping into their petroleum reserves all at the same time right now. So that's all going down right here, right now. Now, the president will be announcing this officially with an address to the American people here a little bit later today. So again, I'll be watching that closely to see if he mentions anything else that may be of interest to us, but he will be making that official announcement out to the American people here a little bit later. So stay tuned for that as well. Also, we have 89 Democratic representatives who have written a letter to the entire Democratic Party urging them to overlook and completely ignore some of the rulings out of the Senate parliamentarian on the next stimulus package. Now, you probably remember me talking about the Senate parliamentarian in previous videos. So this person is essentially the referee within the Senate when it comes to reconciliation bills. So here's how the whole process works. When we come to a reconciliation bill, just like we're dealing with right now in the Senate and well, just passed through the House about a week and a half ago, this is the reconciliation bill. So there are certain rules that apply when it comes to a reconciliation bill. In other words, it's a partisan package. In other words, it only needs one party to actually support it. Well, as a result of that, there's some certain rules that they need to abide by in order to actually get these passed through Congress. Well, one of the, what I should say is the Senate parliamentarian has ruled a couple different things when it comes to this reconciliation bill. Number one, she has announced that the immigration, as far as the provisions within the package for immigration, the Senate parliamentarian has ruled this cannot be in there. It is not part of the reconciliation rules. Therefore, it cannot be in here. Well, representatives like AOC and 89 total representatives within the House have written and signed a letter telling the entire Democratic Party that the Senate parliamentarian rulings are essentially just guidelines and that we should overlook and completely override the rulings from the Senate parliamentarian. So in other words, they're basically saying when it comes to play ball on the field, let's just ignore the referee and let's just play ball anyway based on our rules that we say. Now again, I'm not saying that we should agree or disagree. I'm just simply telling you this is literally what they're saying. So this letter was just announced yesterday, and it was signed by 89 representatives in the House. So, kind of interesting. Makes me wonder what else out there within this package right now that the Senate parliamentarian may come out and say, this isn't within the rules, and they may say, hey, we don't care. Let's just override it anyway, because this is just a guideline that we're supposed to follow. So, Kind of interesting. One other thing that I want to mention too. Remember back in March of this year when we were talking through the final days on the American Rescue Plan? That was the last $1.9 trillion package that contained the $1,400 stimulus checks. There was a couple of provisions within that one that the Senate parliamentarian actually ruled out, including the $15 per hour minimum wage. Well, she ruled that one out and they had to remove it as a result of Senate parliamentarian rules. However, this time they're basically saying, forget about the Senate parliamentarian, let's just do our own thing. So, kind of interesting how that's playing out, right? All right, so President Biden has also confirmed he will be running for a second term in 2024. Kind of interesting. Yeah, 2024. At the same time, he will be 82 at that time. Well, as of right now, he is already marking the books as the oldest president in record. So, so he said he's going to be running for a second term. Now, maybe correct me if I'm wrong, but I'm pretty sure I remember him saying back when he was running last year, you know, before he was actually president, I thought I remember him saying he was only going to be running for one term. Maybe I'm wrong, maybe I misheard that, but I'm pretty sure I heard him saying he's just going to be a one-term president by choice. So maybe that changed, I don't know, but I'm pretty sure I heard that. All right, anyway, let's quickly talk about dollar stores. So the almighty dollar store, the favorite store that many of us enjoy going to, spending $10, $15 here and there and getting, it seems like, a bag full of goodies, and it's like, wow, I just got all of this for $10, right? It's a really kind of a cool thing, right? You walk into a store, you buy anything you want on the shelves for $1 each. Well, those days are gone. That's not happening anymore. Dollar stores have announced that they will no longer be selling products, most of their products anyway, for $1. Because of inflation, they just cannot make it anymore selling products for $1. So prices will be rising on the vast majority of products within dollar stores. So we can give a huge thank you to all of the inflation going on right now that even the stores that all of us have relied on for $1 products and have on our back, apparently, they don't even have that anymore. So these dollar stores will be rising prices. I did not see a specific date when all of these raises to prices will actually be implemented, but it does seem that these dollar stores will be raising prices on the vast majority of their products within a relatively short period of time here. So, of course, all of these stores and everybody like this that continues to raise prices, they continue to cite the supply chain issues and inflation. I mean, it all comes down to the same thing, right? The fact is a lot of places can't get their products on their shelves, as well as, you know, prices are costing a lot more to get things across the ocean with all of these container ships. Container prices are way higher to get that freight moved across the country. It's all adding up, and ultimately it all flows back to us, the consumer, which is a really sad and unfortunate situation. So, interesting note. My wife was at the dollar store just a couple days ago. Actually, it was about a week and a half ago. She was at the dollar store and she said, it is weird. There are shelves completely empty and then randomly there's like one product sitting on a shelf, right? The last one product that nobody wants to buy or something. But she's like, it's weird. Within the dollar store, there are complete aisles that are empty. Totally empty. It's almost like weird, like they're resetting the store or almost like they're just kind of like opening up the store, right? But yeah, kind of weird stuff out there going on right now. But one other announcement, and I've seen this in a number of locations, but as a result of this reconciliation bill, one of the provisions within it is to tax large corporations who have $1 billion or more of profits at a minimum of 15% tax. Well, this is in line with what the president has been saying for many months now, for a very long time, which is this reconciliation bill will not tax anybody under $400,000 of income. Well, okay, maybe that's true, as in those people earning under $400,000 of income will not be directly taxed from the IRS. But here's what's happening. All of these larger corporations who have $1 billion or more of income, of profits, I should say, and they're going to be paying this minimum 15% tax. Here's what's going to happen. And this is according to many, many articles and many, many sources that I've been finding. I've been seeing this for a long time now. But what's happening is all of these inflated prices and all of these taxes on these large corporations, all they're going to do, according to what they're saying, is they're just going to jack up prices and flow all of that back to, once again, yes, us, the consumer. So essentially, it's not a direct tax on us, the consumer, but yet as a result of them raising prices on all of these corporations, they're just going to flow that right back to the consumer because they need to raise their prices on their products in order to account for the raises rising in taxes that they need to pay on all of their profits, right? So ultimately, it's basically like a indirect tax on all of the American people, once again, because we have to brunt all of those higher costs so that they can make their margins. So, yep, you're right. It's not an exact tax right on us, the American people, right out of the IRS, but it is an indirect tax through higher prices through the products and services that we need to buy each and every day, right? So, oh, yeah. Another loaded video. Seriously, there's a lot going on right now. There's so much going on right now. But again, I'm going to be watching that announcement out of the president here a little bit later. He's going to be announcing officially that $50 million barrel reserve release of oil to help alleviate some of the prices at the pump right now. But again, I'm going to continue watching that. You never know what something's going to be said right now with everything going on, but the president will be out a little bit later. If you want to watch that, feel free to tune in. Otherwise, I will watch that closely. I'll bring you back any updates that he announces. Maybe there's going to be something else in there. We're not really sure. All that we knew yesterday is that the president was going to be out today announcing something to the American people. Well, we didn't really know. There was a little bit of leakage. That's a weird word, leakage yesterday, as far as what the president would be talking about today. But this is what we know as of now, early this morning, that announcement came out. So we don't know if there's anything else that the president will be talking about today in his announcement, or if it's strictly going to be talking about these reserves as far as the oil, the 50 million barrels. So either way, I'll be here for you each and every day. Make sure to subscribe down below. If you haven't done so yet, share this video or any others here on the channel with your friends, family, social media. Go back and check out some of the other nearly 2,000 videos right here on the channel. And remember, I'm here on your team every single day. I want to help you out in any way that I can, as I'm doing research all day, every day, boiling it all down into these short videos to help you out in any way that I can. Enjoy. I really appreciate your support. Have a nice day. Stay safe. And I'll see you again later.